How are you doing, folks? And I don't know about you, but currently I am feeling like just absolutely $1 million. And that is, of course, $1 million in current US dollars, which is to say, completely worthless. Did you get it? It was an inflation joke. It's funny because I can't afford gas. But seriously, guys, just when we're starting off, if you don't say, I feel very bad right now because this video that you're currently watching should have been done a very long time ago. I filmed all this a long time ago, finished doing this a long time ago. I just haven't been able to make myself come and edit this video. And I've needed to, and I feel really bad because I want to do more stuff here on YouTube, but I'm just not doing it. I just don't have the energy inside of me to do it, but I've felt very driven recently and have a lot of big stuff on the way, but that's not why you're here. Let's get into why you're here. And that is, of course, the Damascus billet that I am working on today that I'm going to eventually use to make a Bunka chef's knife. I've been cooking a lot more recently, and while I've traditionally made a lot of breakfast food, I've been venturing out into non-breakfast foods, which you sometimes need a knife for. And so this is just the kind of knife that I think I would like to use the most. It has a very flat blade with a slight curve. You chop more than roll when you slice. Big difference, I know. But I like the knife a lot. I'm excited to make the handle, which will be later. But today we're making the Damascus billet I'm going to use to make the knife. And I'm going to walk you through the first part real quick because I didn't have my camera with me at the time due to extenuating circumstances. So I filled it with my phone, but I'll walk you through it real quick, and it's real quick and easy. Let's go. So the billet I'm starting out with is just a simple 5-layer Damascus billet. The two outside layers are leaf spring steel. The two in between that are cut out from old saw blades. And the one in between that is a random bar of metal I had in my shop that I didn't know what was, but assumed and hoped would contrast well. I know that video wasn't great, but stick with me. That gets way better here in a second. But after I got all those cut out, I simply welded them together and welded a stick on the end for a handle, threw it up into the forge. And since I can never afford a power hammer, I just had to use the powerful jacked up arms that I got on me to stick this together with a sledgehammer on a broomstick. And then I folded it over one time, and then I folded it over again the opposite way. So if you're keeping count, that was 5 layers folded hamburger style and to 10 layers, and then that folded hot dog style into 20 layers. Math. And it was actually at this point that I stopped working on the billet that day because I was extremely tired from a variety of things, but I came back the next day with a friend to help me film. He helped me hammer, he helped me hold it, and I think all of it looks fantastic. So here we go, drawing out that billet and twisting it and grinding it and making it shiny. Let's go.
Live alive on my knees. You got something coming, something coming, because
out and twisted up. I left it over in the forge to cool off after I got done forging it out, and I took it over the grinder. I ground it all down flat and smooth. I made sure one side was perfectly smooth and flat. The other side didn't really have to be nearly as much because I'm not forge welding this side, because what I'm going to do is now I'm going to cut this in half.
I'm gonna take this piece of old file. It's probably W1 steel, which is a really hard tool steel, and that'll be the edge of the blade. So I'm gonna cut this in half. I'm going to sandwich it on both sides of this file. I'm going to cut to the same size. And I can kind of get a feel for where the pattern is just based on after it's ground out, because the steel's kind of grind differently. So what I'm going to do is figure out the way I want this to look when I get done, weld it on that way. First thing I do is got to cut it and weld it. So let's go do that. And try to make sure all of these forge weld together. I have to forge this down completely flat and just draw it out, because if I try to shape it or anything while I'm forging it, that piece of W1 from that file might not stay in the center. So I'm gonna do my best to just keep this flat and straight and just rip it right on out. So let's go. Before we start any new project, we're going to work on shop a little bit. It's very dirty. This is not the kind of image you want to put out of yourself on the internet.
Yeah, I was gonna start on all that, but I really want to get this knife going, and I knew if I started doing it, the shop would get dirtier anyway, so I didn't think there was a point in starting cleaning before I started the project.
Yeah, well, if I was you, I might take a break after a knife project if it is for a little bit. Clean up shop some. Make it look nice and pretty.
Yeah, you got a point. This one might be a two-parter.
Figure all that out. I'm going to check on the Nikita. Have fun, and I'll get this end up.
And that is where I left the project at quite some time ago. I haven't worked on that at all since then. This is actually the billet right here, still completely unchanged from the last time you saw it. It still needs to be drawn out more. There's still a lot of things that need to be done on this project. There's the whole actual knife part left, which I will be filming, hopefully, more consistently than I did this video. But I really do appreciate you just sticking along the whole time with this video. I didn't make a whole lot of progress. I made my first ever Damascus steel billet, which I am extremely excited about and very proud of, and I think it's at least in the state that's usable. But I am planning on doing a lot with this YouTube channel, so I really hope you would consider subscribing and liking this video and sticking around. I haven't posted consistently here ever, but I already have a video that I'm working on that should be coming out next week, and I have one enormous project that I'm working on. I'm not sure when that's going to be coming out, but I have tons of ideas to do with this channel. And I love making longer form videos, and I love getting to do photography and videography stuff with this. So if you are enjoying the vibes present, I hope you would stick around and consider subscribing. I'm planning on trying to start a couple different things. I want to start, like, a subreddit or a Discord or something, not because there's, like, thousands of people that want one, but just because if we're going to have a community, I want it to be a community. So if that's something you're interested in, I will do that. Just let me know. If you stick around, if you've stuck around this long, thank you so much. I really do appreciate it. I'd give you a big old kiss, but I don't know if you consent, so I can't do that. And I hope you have an absolutely spectacular day, and I will see you on the flip side. Deuces!